Greetings, programs. My name is Wretch, and I'd like to welcome you to the start of an adventure set a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. This is the beginning of my playthrough of Star Wars The Old Republic, one of my top three MMO games. And that makes complete sense because two out of the three of those MMOs are Star Wars games. We're going to be doing a playthrough of the Bounty Hunter class, which is available to the Sith Empire. I played all of the other Sith classes except for Bounty Hunter, so I'm looking forward to an awesome story and environment that only BioWare can bring. So let's go ahead and get to it. As you can see, you can choose your allegiance at character creation. You can choose between the Galactic Republic and the Sith Empire. And since the Galactic Republic isn't really what we're kind of going for, let's be bad guys. So, the Sith have four classes that they can choose from. You have the Sith Warrior and the Sith Inquisitor. Those are both Force-using classes. Got the good old Bounty Hunter there. And the Imperial Agent. The Imperial Agent is actually the one I played the most. My main character that I have on my account is an Imperial Agent. Let's go ahead and get with Bounty Hunter. And here you have the races that are available to you to play these classes. This symbol means that you can buy them from the cartel market, which you pay real-world money to unlock some of the stuff in the game, or to get the coins to unlock it in the game. Tor is free to play, but I'm a subscriber, so I get access to quite a few things. So these are the five that we're going to use. And you have the humans, obviously, the cyborgs, the Zabrak, who their most famous member would most likely be Darth Maul from Phantom Menace. You got the Ratataki, whose most famous member would be Ventress from the Clone Wars cartoon and series. And then the Chiss. Grand Admiral Thrawn from the Timothy Zahn Heir to the Empire trilogy was a Chiss, and he was the first Chiss. And if you've never read that trilogy, go ahead and do so, because it's probably one of my favorite Star Wars stories ever. So for the purposes of this character, we're going to play a cyborg, and I'll tell you guys the kind of vibe we're wanting to give to this guy.
If there's payment involved, I'm interested.
Good stuff. So this character I'm going to base loosely off of Angel Eyes, the bounty hunter from the Good, Bad, the Ugly Western. I want a character who is extremely immoral, and he has somewhat of a code of honor, but it's solely to the contract. No matter how bad the contract, you know, bad the deed that he has to do because of the contract, if he's paid for it, he's going to do it come hell or high water. So I think that's kind of a good character to have. So we have the choice of body types. It looks like skinny, average, muscular, and hoss. I think we're going to go with regular. And let's just start back here. Kind of an Asian vibe. Not really what I'm looking for. Let's try that. Now, let's go ahead and get his skin color a little more pale so I can see what I'm working with here. Now, scarring. I need him to have some scarring predominantly around his eyes for the theme that I'm looking for, or at least for the look. So let's go. Well, I got some burn marks there. That's the Harrison Ford scar. Let's just run Final Fantasy VIII. Oh, that looks lovely. Need something with both of his eyes involved in the process. Oh. You want to know how I got these scars? Got scar across one eye. Okay, I like that. That looks like scarring or really deep burns around his eyes. That's perfect. Now let's go for complexion. Want something a little bit rugged looking. Well, that could work. Let's keep look. Oh, there we go. A little bit of 5 o'clock shadow. That's what we need. Eye color, we'll go ahead and go green. It doesn't really matter, and you'll see why. Now, you choose the cyborg cybernetics, and as you can see, you get a choice of your cybernetics, and I believe it does add facial hair. So the only thing that really sucks about choosing the cyborg is you can't choose the cybernetics and the facial hair. You have to choose like a combo. And there is one specifically that I am looking for. There we go. That's what I'm looking for. Kind of the Fu Manchu with those dead cybernetic looking eyes. Kind of looks like that dude from Ghost in the Shell. Let's give him some proper hair. Actually, let's make the hair color... Let's give him a good, yeah, good villainous black. Now, in terms of hairstyles, Star Wars either has some awesome hair or some absolutely abysmal hair. Or anime hair. So let's see if we can find something that's gonna fit this guy. Kind of a wild gunfighter. That kind of worked. Just the slicked back hair. And that's not really what I'm... Oh, I like that with the top knot in the back. And the kind of tribal looking beads. That reminds me of the Wookiee scalps that Boba Fett carries over his shoulder. Yeah, let's go with that. That kind of looks cool. Let's scan out. Yeah, that doesn't look like a guy to be trifled with. Cool. Now we gotta see if his name's been taken. I have an idea for a name. We want to call this guy Beaudry. And Beaudry is the name of a half-Apache bounty hunter and Texas Ranger from a series of short stories by the author Louis L'Amour, who is probably one of the best Western authors of all time. But Beaudry sounds like a good name. Didn't want to give him anything like Master Blaster or anything like that. Just his name. That's all people need to know him by. So let's see if it's taken. And it's not. Good stuff. Now, I believe we are going to get that awesome opening. And for the purposes of narration, because you don't talk during this thing, I will keep my mouth shut until we land planet side. I'm still loading there just a little bit. Man, I'll never get tired of that. Now, to go ahead and go along with the story for the people who may not have read that, I'm a young gunfighter, and we have just landed on Hutta, which is one of the Hutt homeworlds, or transplanted homeworlds. Their actual homeworld, Varl, is no longer habitable. But we're here on Hutta to try and make our way into the Great Hunt, which is apparently a contest between bounty hunters across the galaxy trying to find the most wanted criminals and fugitives, and basically, fortune and glory, kid. Fortune and glory. And that looks like me up ahead. Yep, that's me. And looks like we got some Gamorrean shaking some civilians down. Oh, he looks awesome. Okay, there's a guy running. Oh, he's got Gamorreans after him. Run, you fool! Looks like Beaudry's kind of place. Checking my mission profile, I guess, while this gentleman seems to have had one too many.
Almost set up. See if you can't get that security network running, Mako.
Sure thing, Brayden. We'll be... hey, now.
Indeed. The main attraction has arrived. Team, this is the man we're pinning all our hopes on. Best shot I've ever seen in nerves of steel. He's great hunt material, all right. What do you say, Hunter? Ready to meet your team?
Okay, so I guess this guy, Brayden, is my mentor. I'm the gunfighter, and he's the old bounty hunter who's taken me under his wing. Absolutely, boss.
My team. I like the sound of that.
Get used to the idea. To win the Great Hunt, you'll need support, structure, and intel. Let's do things official-like. This is Mako, little genius I picked up years ago in Nar Shaddaa. She provides intel and tech.
Hope you're as good as the old man says.
And the big bruiser is Jory. He handles the heavy lifting and provides security for our base of operations.
Greetings. I am at your disposal. Feel free to make us all incredibly wealthy and famous. He's a Klaatuian, if I don't miss my guess, and Mako must be, I guess, my version of Q from James Bond. Looks like a good mix.
Cute girls and big guns. I'm sold.
Alright, enough introductions. Down to business. We're here because the Great Hunt has been called. Little Mako is the most rabid fan of hunter history this side of Geonosis, and even she doesn't know exactly what the Great Hunt entails.
I do know the names of every Great Hunt winner, though. Bloodworthy, the Defenestrator, Jewel and Nightbringer.
Every bounty hunter who's won a Great Hunt went on to massive glory and riches, which is why we're here.
Well, I am here for credits.
You can keep your glory. I just want to be rich.
You see? This man understands the way the galaxy works.
Here's what I know so far. The Great Hunt has two groups, the Mandalorian Elite and Freelance Bounty Hunters sponsored by influential crime lords. There's no time to make you a Mandalorian. That means you need a sponsor.
Nimro the Hutt runs this stinking little town. I've got just enough pull with that gangster to get you an introduction. Mako, scan for every bounty in the area. I want the nastiest, most brutal, untouchable scum you can find.
I'm on it, Brayden. One nasty character coming up.
We need to get you situated as a big-time hunter, at least as far as the locals know. Then we contact Nimro. Mako will plant rumors about your off-world exploits. But you have to take down someone impressive and local to sell the reputation.
Well, if Firefly taught us anything, it's all about reputation. Now just point me the right way.
You find a target, and I'll take it down hard.
How's that scan coming, Mako?
Found something. Check this out. Vex, Corellian. Champion quick draw artist, wanted for robbing 15 Imperial military pay stations.
Of all places to get credits, why would a sane being rob an Imperial pay station?
Perfect. This Vex is either a madman or a glory hound, and he's obviously dangerous.
Says here, Vex has a safe house in the bad part of town, right in the heart of the madness. That'll be fun.
Nimro the Hutt's enemy took over part of this town. It's dangerous poking around in there, but it's your best shot. Raid Vex's safe house and look for something that might help us track him down, but be ready for anything.
Hey, I'm ready for everything.
Excuse me, but I have a safe house to shoot up.
Be safe out there.
Okay. Well, looks like these are our guys. Good first start. Now, you see that green door ahead of us. Certain areas are blocked off by either red or green doors. You can enter the green ones, you can't enter the red ones, you see? Bounty hunter phase, you're not eligible to enter at this time. And there are different phases for different classes. As you can probably, I don't know if there's one close by, But I believe there's one for the agent around here too that I can't enter because I'm not that class. Where are we? The Poison Pit Cantina. And looks like we have some people already willing to give us quests.
Welcome to Hada, kid. You're new here. You look pretty tough. But let me give you a word of advice. Watch your back out there. Learn how to please the people in charge. And as soon as you can, get out.
Well, don't you worry about me.
I don't plan to stay any longer than I have to.
You got a good head on you then. Just hope that when you're ready to leave, you still can. There's a gang war raging out there right now. If you want to survive on Hada, you're gonna have to learn the ropes. I can get you experience navigating Hada's gangs, help you build your reputation, if you help me out.
See, it's all about reputation. But nothing's ever free there, Lou. His name's Lou Brell.
Of course. There's always a catch.
This is a gangster town, controlled by a greedy and cruel hut named Nemro. As if there was any other kind. Used to be I worked for Nemro's gang. Violent, bloody life. That's why I left. But now, my little brother's following my footsteps.
That's a family
Nemro's
affair.
Nemro's street gang leader, Rex Gear, is my old buddy. I thought he might help get my brother out. But I can't get to Rex for all the fighting.
Okay, so what do you need?
Where do I come in?
If you could blast your way through them and talk to Rex, convince him to let my brother go, I'd be grateful.
Okay, well, grateful doesn't pay my bills. Is there pay?
And what exactly do I get out of this, besides a reputation?
I told you what you stand to gain in terms of reputation, but if that's not enough, I think I can swing some credits.
Good. Contract, finalized.
You got yourself a deal.
Glad to hear it. You'll find Nemro's boys holed up in Jaguna, but you're gonna need to fight through Fathra's thugs, so be careful.
Cool. So we got our first, non-class quest from Lou Brell there. Let's talk to, this cute little Nemro bounty droid. Carrying urgent message, sent by Nemro the Hutt, all-powerful ruler of Jaguna. Okay, well, give me the message.
I'll listen. For now.
I am Mighty Nemro, ruler of Jaguna. Citizens, hear me. My city is under siege from the craven Fathra and his followers. These criminals wage a legal war against me in the streets. Eradicate all of Fathra's people who dare to set foot in Jaguna. Cripple this coward's army and you will know the honor and rewards of serving the great and powerful Nemro the Hutt. You sure Nemro will pay?
You don't seem entirely reliable.
Nemro honors all deals. Fathra's in violation of the Hutt cartel. Tell Nemro job accepted, relieved. Nemro would turn me into scrap if the message failed. Oh, well, we don't want to do that to that little bounty droid. Good stuff. Now, we always go ahead and tap these. These are basically our quick travel waypoints. Looks like we already have that one unlocked. And you can see the PC characters running around. Doing their business the same as us. And check this out. Look how beautiful that is. Now, we're on Hutta, and that is Nar Shaddaa. Basically, think of an underworld version of Coruscant. You know, the huge city. But it's a small moon, but that's where you go if you need anything seedy done. We're going to check our mail real quick. Since I have been playing this game since it first came out, all my characters usually start out with something. So let's just get through this real quick. Founder of the Republic title, since I was there at the beginning. First anniversary fireworks, don't really have any need for those. Basic commendations can be used to purchase entry-level gear for group content at level 55. Ooh, okay, we'll take that. Anniversary package. Fireworks, don't care. Imperial Scout paint job. That's for the Starfighter expansion, which we'll get into probably in future episodes. And we have some pilot suits. We're going to go ahead and take the Imperial ones, and we have a test pilot title. We'll take that. an Imperial Battle Ace pilot suit, and the Imperial Covert pilot suit. And, actually, let's go ahead and delete that mail now. Don't want any dirty Alliance spacesuits. We got ourselves a little droid, an MT-40 astromech droid, which is cool. Nice to have a little companion running around with us. And this is the same, exact same mail. Gives us the title of the Illustrious. So let's just delete these. And check our inventory. We're just using all the stuff to, all these items so we can get on the road here. Nikki has invited you to join Hydra. Would you like to join this guild? No. I don't think Beaudry's gonna join any guilds or run with people. He's gonna be a loner. Let's get our little droid here. Aww. White and blue. He's awesome. And the Illustrious title. And we're not using any of our titles right now. At least we better not be. And let's hit add. Also, we talked to this droid right here. He's the speeder, basically the transport service.
Stage your destination.
And you talk to them to discover the next terminal. So we're out here, and here you see. Oh, that bounty hunter's just getting right to it. Nemro thugs. And I'm not exactly sure how to play bounty hunter. I'm just pressing the buttons right now. Let's go ahead and look at our attacks. We'll loot first. Alright, we have rapid shots. Fires a quick stream of bolts, causing 32 to 50 weapon damage. Missile blast. Deals 54 to 55 kinetic damage to the target and 7-8 additional kinetic damage to up to 3 nearby enemies in a 5-meter radius. That'll be good for tagging groups for AoE. If the primary target is weak or a standard enemy, it is knocked to the ground. And vent heat. Rapidly vents 50 heat over 3 seconds. And that generates 25 heat. Okay, I have a friend of mine who actually plays Bounty Hunter, and he told me that a lot of this is generating heat and then dispersing it into a big attack. So it's essentially like combo points in a way. So let's rocket these Fothra gangsters. And get to doing this first quest. This is the one for the droid who was talking on behalf of Nemro. Oh, here's some more. Hit the missile blast, and that tags all of them. And I really don't want to join Hydra, man. There we go. Defeat Fothra's gangsters. Planetary commendation and a med pack. Oh, and we're already level 2. That's a good start. Now, we can see here on our radar, at the bottom right hand, we have some other places to go into. Let's try here first. No, not... Ooh, hello. Just walked into a looting. Rex gear. Oh, this is for... to rescue the little brother.
You got some skill breaking through Fothra's line, and some nerve coming in here. Do I know you?
Now, let's make this quick.
I don't have time for this. I'm here for the bro kid.
What do you want with him? You working for Fothra too?
Well, I work for the kid's family right now.
His brother sent me to get him out of the gang.
Lou sent you, huh? I wish I could say that made things different, but it just don't work that way. The Brell kid's a traitor. First time Fothra's thugs start shooting at us, he turns coward and tries to join their side. Nemro's gonna have a lot of questions for him, and I can't let him go.
That doesn't sound like my problem. My employer won't approve.
His big brother isn't gonna like that. And believe me, you don't want to mess with him.
Then he should have come here himself.
Ouch.
Look, I don't want to.
That's true, though.
So how about I pay you some credits and you go on your way? Tell Brell's big brother you got here too late or something. You'll be richer, and this weasel will get what he has coming.
Well, he's offering me some more money, but like I said, this character honors all of his contracts, good or bad. So let's go ahead and honor it. And you can see here, the decisions give you either dark side points, represented by the red upside down triangle, or light side points with the blue starburst.
Hey, I have a better idea. You let Brell go, and he and his brother leave Hutta, and nobody knows any different.
What am I supposed to tell the boys? Turn coward and get a free pass off Hutta?
That kind of sounds like your problem. Would you rather get shot?
You work with me, or I'll shoot you in the face.
All right. Looks like you got lucky, bro. Your big brother's hired muscle just saved your skin.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, you're welcome. Get lost.
You better get out of here, too. The boys won't be happy when they find out what you did.
Well, if they have a problem, they can file a complaint with the proper department. That department being the muzzle of my blaster. Now, we've got another place we can... Ah! Getting shot at. Hi. Where? You guys. That was not nice. Eat wrist rocket. I like it. Let's go ahead and head in here. And I think this is the... Yeah, Bounty Hunter. This is the safe house. For Vex. Hired Outlaw. Vex chose poorly. There's another one here behind the crate near the bed. Guess he was just waiting for trouble. Hello? And is Vex here? No. Looks just like another hired outlaw. Let's use the vent heat. Oh, okay. So the vent heat is just kind of a... to keep yourself from getting too heated, I guess, which makes sense. That's not an attack. Okay. Well, here's the data pad. And now we need to return to Brayden with that. One of the things I really like about this game... Well, there's a lot of stuff I like about it, but two things regarding the quests. One... There's quests that have secondary objectives, so instead of just, hey, go kill these guys, it's, well, go kill these guys and see if this thing's over here. You know, there's always a secondary objective to make the quest seem a little bit more epic in scale. And secondly, and this kind of turned me off to World of Warcraft, when you play this game and see these kind of detailed storylines and moral decisions that have to be made, when a WoW NPC asks you to go kill some boars for very little reason, it kind of takes a lot of the fun out of WoW for you. So, you know, but that is what it is. Let's go ahead and turn in our quest to Lou here.
I just heard from my little brother, and it's a good thing, too. Fathra doesn't look like he's about to let up. And if it gets much worse, Nemro might start being more picky about who he lets on board the shuttles.
And my payment?
We better settle up.
I can't thank you enough, kid. Here's the credits I promised. Be careful on Hutta, though. Huts will eat you alive if you let him.
Well, Huts like to eat anything, really. So we get Planetary Commendation, which is basically a kind of currency, and a med pack. And now we have a stim that we can take that'll increase our cunning by 8 for 60 minutes or our aim by 8 for 60 minutes. And if I recall correctly, cunning is for the agents predominantly, and aim is for bounty hunters. So we will take that. And let's go ahead and talk to Brayden. And then I think we'll call it an episode.
I'm just saying I want to go on some missions. My blaster aim is pretty good. Anything's better than sitting around with you in our gear. No offense, big guy.
None taken, little one. You are young and still crave adventure.
Hey, look who's back. How'd it go out there, hotshot? Find anything?
Well, I found this.
Vex left a data pad at his safe house.
Great, give it over and I'll see what I can make of it.
You show much natural skill. I'm honored to join you on the Great Hunt. Well, any news on your end?
What were you two doing while I was gone?
Not much.
Taking care of all the boring details so you don't have to.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Brayden. How was Nimro's palace? We getting our hunter in to see this hut?
I've laid the groundwork, but we're not there yet. What have you got?
A data pad from Vex's safe house. Crack the encryption in record time. Check out that last entry.
Our boy Vex keeps detailed records. There's a receipt here for a shuttle ticket he bought today. We'll have to move fast.
Oh, he's trying to get out of town.
Only the boldest make it into the Great Hunt. And Vex is a bold target. He's a champion gunslinger. Completely ruthless. What do you say, Hunter? You ready to take down Vex all by yourself?
Yeah, of course I am.
I'm always ready.
That's exactly what I wanted to hear. If you head out now, you'll catch Vex at the shuttle port before he escapes. Bring back Vex's ID tags as proof that you're the one who got him. Anything else he carries is yours to keep.
Yep. Good luck, Hunter. Speed and accuracy be yours. We are all depending on you. Well, no pressure. And professional's boots. Heavy armor. Okay, I actually didn't know that bounty hunters started off wearing heavy armor. I thought they may have upgraded. So, get our new armory boots. And I think that's where we'll go ahead and end the episode for right now, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it so far. If you liked the video, go ahead and click like down below. Subscribe to the channel or leave a comment. That'd be a big help. And we'll see you next time. Later days, everyone.